I'm Dr. David Kelsall. I work at Rocky Mountain Ear Center in Denver, Colorado. I started doing cochlear implant surgery as a resident. I performed over 1,000 cochlear implants in the last 28 years, so a lot of good experience with it. The message we're really trying to get out to patients is come in and be evaluated. I mean, you may not be a candidate for a cochlear implant, but since we can implant people now with moderate to profound hearing loss, there are a lot of patients out there that could benefit that are not coming in. For most people, surgery is still a scary part of this whole process, and I think it's the number one reason that people don't come in to get a cochlear implant. I think people still have the understanding that this is a big operation, that this is brain surgery, that it may not be paid for by insurance, that there's a lot of risk associated with it, that it may not work for them, and I think our job is to educate them that a lot of those things just are no longer true. Fortunately, surgery now has become much less involved. It's usually just about an hour in length. And I honestly consider this now a fairly minor operation. It's outpatient. They come in, have it done, home the same day, a couple days at home to recover. That we activate the device at between 10 and 14 days. And then they start using the device and learning to hear with it. The cochlear implant consists of two parts. There's an outer processor, and then the surgical implant itself. So the surgery to put the implant in, again, about an hour procedure. It involves a small incision right behind the ear. We do create a small pocket behind the ear to tuck the implant into that space. We do open what's called the mastoid bone, and by opening that, it allows us to get access to the middle ear space. Once we're in that location, we make a small opening into the cochlea and then slowly thread the electrode into the cochlea. It has 22 different contacts, and they're positioned in a certain way depending on the type of device that we're using. We then test the device. We always make sure the device is functional. We actually do 3 separate tests in the OR. So activation can be a very exciting day for people. When we first start using the device, we'll put the outside processor on, turn the device on for the first time. Can be a very exciting time for people. Children don't know necessarily what they're hearing. It doesn't always sound good to them initially. In fact, we counsel them that it probably will not sound good to them. And really that's because we're giving them the high frequencies back that they haven't heard for many, many years. But their brain over that first 3 to 6 months adjusts to that, and it becomes a much more natural sound to them. We explain it to patients that just like a newborn baby, it takes a while for their brain to understand sound and learn what those sounds mean. It's going to take the brain time to readjust for that. People that have had hearing, that have had a hearing memory, certainly adjust to it much quicker than patients that have not had hearing. We do have a network now of local audiologists that are doing programming, which has really helped with that, so that they can come down, get the surgery, but then stay in their local community or travel less far to get the programming that they need. That's a story that we hear over and over with patients is, why didn't I do this 10 years ago? That's a long time for people to be trying to deal with this level of hearing loss.